It really is amazing. You almost never see this little traffic in the middle of the day on 7th Avenue. When we were here a year or so ago, we saw sidewalks just jam-packed with people, shoulder to shoulder, being forced out into the street because there was no space on the sidewalk. There were real problems for handicapped people, people with strollers. I mean, it was a real dense crush of people. Even long before Corona came around, people were talking about the need for creating more pedestrian space. But now that need has become much more urgent than ever. And there's a lot of streets around here where sidewalks can be widened or they can be closed to through traffic. Look at this, it goes to show you the latent demand for cycling. I mean, people, you never see this many cyclists here under normal conditions. Even that there are so few cars and so few pedestrians, there are way more cyclists than normal. And I think it goes to show just the latent demand for cycling if streets were safer. Because now without so much traffic, it's a lot safer and feels a lot less threatening. And we even saw some kids biking around Times Square, which is something you almost never see. The streets are so unthreatening that people actually can look around and take in the neighborhood and don't just have to be focused on the threats around them. We need to make our streets safe for cycling because it's healthy and it's a spatially efficient way to get around, and there's gonna be a lot of people avoiding the subway, and if those people all start driving, this city's gonna have real problems. This crisis with Corona is not gonna last forever, and the crowds are gonna come back. And if we don't start planning now, we're gonna go back to the same overcrowded, congested public spaces that we had before. This is an opportunity for us to plan and take action to make sure New York comes back better and stronger than ever.